schedule a meeting. So when we go up to schedule a meeting and testing for session, then we can add to Google Calendar. You know probably all of this. The automatic, see, it's a long link because the password's included. So people just have to do one step.
All right.
But what's really important here for some of your questions, I think, edit this meeting, first of all, because I clicked enter, so it saved it. When you're setting up a meeting, of course, you can do reoccurring. This is where it's key. It says registration, and some of these are so faint, it's easy to not see it. You have to click required for registration to come up as an option. And that gives you the option then to pre-assign later. You have to have it through a registration process.
Okay.
Yeah. So I'll go over this again because it's key. So when you schedule a meeting and you're starting to put in your date and time and all of that, right under the reoccurring over here, you say see registration.
Mm-hmm.
You have to click, that's empty. You have to click it on to required. And I'll show you what that does after. But we want to definitely cover as much as we can. So breakout rooms, you can pre-assign, then you save with that registration.
Okay.
Okay. And then some really great things come up. So once you've ticked off registration required and you've saved it, you have to save it first. Mm-hmm. Then you scroll down to the bottom and now new options come up. So for registration, you can edit. This is very exciting. Yeah. You can automatically approve or manually approve. You can have an email sent to you every time someone registers. You can close the registration, allow attendees to join from different devices. That's important. Show social share buttons only if you want it to be an open type event. Okay. And what's really exciting, you can, in that registration form, you click over to questions here. So the first section that we looked at is under registration. The other one's right beside it for questions. And you can have last name, first name's automatic. You can have a phone number or email, job title, whatever you're wanting. Questions and comments, depending on the type of event. But then you can add custom questions. So if you want them to ask them if they want to be added to your email list or permission to, you know, send them resources ahead of time or other questions because you want pre-screened or pre-prep on your part, you can add new questions right here. It can be a short answer or a single answer. And a single answer means they can pick from a couple answers.
Oh.
So it's pretty exciting to be able to do that. And then
you're offering a workshop and people are registering for something that you're offering, but it's not a pre-designed workshop that you're giving. That's what this is.
Well, it could be from even a pre-designed workshop that you have.
Registration?
Yes. The advantage of a registration is that they each get their own unique link. So that helps with security too, where if you don't, there's times we want to just share one link open and wide. And then there's other times we want people to each have their own link that they're not, you know, so there's different pros and cons, but the registration is a great option. And then you can even edit the email that is sent to them upon their registration. So in that email, you might put a link to a workbook.
Hmm.
So it gives you some exciting options. And with branding, you can even upload a banner to the registration page with your logo, or if it's a collaborative effort and you have two logos, as well, And this is where you would also, even without registration, you have the option to set up polls. So this is very quick, you know, on options, but I know these make a difference when we're facilitating online.